Hello dear friends, we continue with these wire rodding coils, deformed bearing coils. Şimdi at first what I want to repeat again. Wire rod in coils, bridge. Deformed bar in coils and rebars in coils. Okay. Sometimes they write rebars in coils. Okay. These are same. What I told you in the wire, there is some scratch, some threads. Okay. These are using for buildings. But this wire, this is rod. Okay. This is direct. There is no thread or there is no scratch. So they just directly use this one for the fabricating nail something. Okay. So these are constructionally are stronger. These are not that much stronger. Okay. This is the first. This is the explanations about the cargo. Okay. Just come to the pictures. Okay, we just start with the cargo. You see, this is the tank top here. And then, one, two, three, four. You see here, four tier. This four tier, they just first load with the bulldozer. Same like here. And then, okay, finish here, remaining pull, because here on the top, you know, the cross deck, here is under deck area. Crane cannot reach directly here. Correct? My cargo hold. Pardon. This is cargo hold. I am just driving very extremely. Okay, this is forward. This is aft. When they load with the crane cannot, because they are loading with the slings, cannot reach the corner. Okay, they just fill here four tier. Also 40 yer here and then this pool directly load with the crane level. Okay, and then they just put some plates, put the bulldozer again. Okay, the remaining tier they just load and then fill the pool again. Okay, this is the loading method for this cargo. Ha, if you are in bulk carrier, okay, they will load like this, but if you are a box shape vessel, they will load directly. It will no problem. There is no headache like this. And if it is a box shape, very very easy to load this cargo. Okay. And then I want to just roughly want to tell about the calculation. How many ton I will load? Okay, golden rule. What we are doing at first. Okay. How many? What is the packing list? Okay. How many ton from which kind? And what about the load list? Discharging port, how many ton I will discharge? Okay. This cargo, don't forget. This cargo, what is this? Tamam, okay. This cargo actually very light cargo. One wire rodding coil, one coil is about 2 ton. Okay. Don't forget about the tank top strength. I have never seen there is some tank top strength with this cargo. Think this cargo same like steel scrap cargo, because it is the okay, this is my bundle, this is the rods like this like this, and then okay, this is my rod bundles. This is very light, inside is empty, just nothing. You can put too much, but what about one of the important thing? If you are loading wire rodding coils, okay. I am talking about the general rules, okay. Now I am talking about general rules. For example, I open that photo. Yes. Maximum tier. Okay. Maximum tier. So here is one, two, three, four. I will put here another one, another one, another one, another one. If this is wire rod, maximum 11. Okay. Pardon. 11. This is just general. 10 to 11. Okay. If it is deformed bearing coil, rebar in coil, okay. 12 tier. So you can stack this cargo top of it, top of it, top of it, top, top, top until the high, maximum 12 or 11 tier. Don't forget this one. Ha, if according to your loading plan, if the, you want to load more, actually you have to agree with the receiver and the loader and the shipper, receiver actually with the charter. Okay, because if you tell them I will load 15 tier, maybe shipper will not want to load like this. And then they will ask you about a guarantee letter. Because if I load too much cargo to top of it, maybe the down cargo on the tank top will be with the weight of the cargo, will change the shape and the damage the cargo. Okay, don't forget this one. This is very very important. This is stackable cargo. You can put each of them top of it, but how many tier you can load? It is very very important. Okay, this is one of the golden rule. Remaining actually little same with these debars. Okay, what I am doing in that case? I ask about the load list, packing list. Okay, how many ton? How many? Actually, size are almost same with this one, that sometimes changing the size. So I group according to load, according to size. Okay, I will load this one, but for that cargo actually the big coils to down, small coils to top is a general rule. Okay, this is my vessel. Okay, pardon, this is my aft, this is my forward. Okay, this is my operation area. Okay, my vessel is 3 cargo hold again. Yeah, it can be 5, 7, 9, no problem. Okay, maybe 2. It is not a problem. So, what was I doing normally? Okay, if any draft restriction, something, any draft limitations, okay. For the, I just distribute the cargo, same like bulk carrier. Bulk cargos, correct. To catch the target trim. Correct. And then, okay, hold number one, let's say 3,000. 3,000 here. 3,000 here. 3,000 here. Okay, just I am talking roughly. Okay, I calculate this one. Okay, let's say hold number one, 2,500. Okay. I calculate, okay, and then what will I do? If my vessel is box shape vessel, actually very very easy to calculate. This is my cargo hold, correct? What is the beam? What is the length? What is the area? So, what I told you in just in Turkey? What is the diameter? 1.2. What is the length? 1.35. Okay. Pardon, if I multiply this to, (sighs) 1.35, multiply with 1.2, okay, 1.6 square meter, okay, this one. So, what is my tank top area? Let's say 1,620 square meter, just about, okay. And then what is one of my coil? This one is 1.26 square meter. So it will take 1,000 pieces in one layer, correct? This is the calculation. And then what one of the important thing here? Okay, my first layer will take 1,000 pieces, correct? Okay, like this, like this, like this, and then going like this. Okay, but the other layer will not take 1,000 actually. What I told you before, this is my cargo hold, for example. This is one coil here, one coil here, one coil, other and other here. But the top you can load like this. Don't forget this one. In the coils you cannot load like this. Here is if this is down. Okay. You cannot load like this. Forget this one. You can load like this. Here. Here. Okay. So if here is 5 pieces, here will be 4 pieces. And then here will be 5 pieces again. Correct? And then here will be 4 pieces again. Because the curve between the coils, you cannot put here. You should put like this. Correct? So here, you can calculate how many pieces here. And in the next tier, that much pieces, that much, that much, that much. So in one layer, how many ton? 1,000. The next one, for example, the next layer, for example, 900. 1,000 here, 900 here, 1,000 here. And then what will happen? For example, hole number 3. First tier, 1,000. Second tier, 900. Last tier, 1,000. So total, 2,900. Correct. And then I need to load 100 ton more. So side to side, port side to starboard side. How many pieces it take? Let's say 10 pieces. So what about the weight of this one? 2 ton, only 2 ton. Correct. So in one row, how many pieces? It takes 10 pieces. So 2 ton, it will make 20 ton. Correct. So 5 row more here. I just load like this. Generally, what they are doing for the if it is last row, because this is your hatch cover, correct? Hatch opening, this area. They don't put forward enough. Just directly, they just load in the middle like this. 5 row here, okay. 5 pieces. It is going side to side. But what is important here? If this, for example, this is, I just draw like this, okay. This is first row, second row, fourth row. For example, if one row is half, okay. This is important. You cannot leave the top rows the half. Very important. If it is half, they must make lashing, okay. I will explain how they will make the lashing also. I will show in the photos, okay. This is the general rules according to this one. Okay, we continue with the photos. You see, if one row is half, for example, this is only like this. For the lashing, for this one, they can they generally make with the belt slings, okay. Not with the wires, steel wires. Belt sling with the ratchet tensioner by hand they are making. Okay. Not same like steel straps with the coils, okay. And then what is the golden rule? The rule is Audi rule. What is Audi rule? They must make the lashing like this. If they take from here, for example, like this. And then the other one, for example, has to make like this. And then the other one has to make like this. Not if this lashing finish here, the next lashing cannot start from here. Correct. Must be like this. Okay. Must be like this. The lashings must be like this. This is the Audi rule for the lashing. The down layers not important. But for example, if you have some load separation, for example, okay, first the last discharging port, the tank top cargo will be the, for example, in same like that picture. Okay, what should I do? Okay, here is side to side, no problem. Side to side, side to side, side to side. There is no need lashing actually. If your cargo is side to side, even if in the middle of the hold, what I told you, first row, first tier, second tier, third tier, and the remaining 5 row, they just put in the middle of the cargo. If it is side to side, actually no need any lashing. It is better if you make, but if it is side to side, it will not move. Okay, don't forget. But if it is half, even if in the down, when you discharge, first discharging port, second discharging port, for example, for the last discharging port, Even if it is on the tank top, if it is half, for example, here must be meklashik, because when you discharge all the cargo, for example, on the tank top, here is some half row remaining here, must be lashit with the others. Because when you go to sailing, it will move in the top of the cargo hold. It is very, very important also. So, after each load, if any half row, must make lashing. If it is side to side, actually no need. So, what is important? As much as possible. For example, I will discharge in three holds, port. Okay. I am just drawing one hold. For example, this is my cargo hold. For example, this I will discharge three lot in for hold number. For example, this is hold number three. Okay. I will load three type of cargo, three lot cargo, three different. For three different discharging port, okay. As much as possible, one load make level. So when finished, for example, so that is why this is first discharging port, this is second discharging port, this is third discharging port. So when I discharge this cargo, my cargo in the voyage will be like this, correct? It is very good because almost level. And then when I go to second discharging port, I discharge my cargo, okay. It is also level. Very good. So no need lashing, no need time consumption. Also when you are discharging, they don't need to open the lashings, not time consumption. Okay. Very, very important. As much as possible, consider this one. This, for example, I am just drawing an example. This is not a good practice. Okay. For example, this is my cargo hold. This is forward, this is aft. Okay, this is forward. This is aft. I am looking from the side. Okay. This is my first lot. And then, for example, this is my second lot. And then, for example, for just like, not like this. I am just erasing this one. Şöyle. And for example, this is my third lot. So this is first discharging port, this is second, this is third. Okay, I will discharge the cargo, I will go to sail. You see here very high. This high maximum 3 tier, don't forget. 3 tiers. If it is, for example, in that case only 1 tier, okay, no problem. Here 2 tier, no problem. If 3 tier, here one more tier, no problem. But if it is more than, if it is like a wall very high, it is no good also. Okay. Maximum 3 tiers here. So that is why I am telling as much as possible level here. Okay, I discharge. Nerede? Eraser here. Okay, first cargo, first discharging port, I erase. You see my cargo. No good shape actually for sailing. Okay, and then I go to second discharging port. I discharge also this cargo. You see, for the last discharging port shape is not good. Here is very high, for example. Here is 2 tier, for example. Here is 4 tier. No good. Very big pool. Very big empty area here. As much as possible, same level. That is why before loading, you must make your calculations very good. You not think only about the loading, also you think about discharging. After discharging, what will be the shape of the cargo inside the cargo hold? It is very, very important. If it is safe for navigation, if any, some half rows, if some tiers, more than four, and in front of it, empty. So it is not good. Okay. So that is why before you must make calculations very, very good. What is the beam? My cargo hold like, pardon. What is the beam? What is the length? So what is the area? In one layer, how many pieces, coils I will take? And then second tier, third tier, okay, first row, first lot, for example, will be four tier. Ha, very good, okay. You will tell them, this is forward, this is aft. What was the loading method? Because this is hatch cover opening, correct? Here is the free area for the crane loading, but here they cannot load with the crane. Ha, what is important? So you will tell them, okay, with the bulldozer at first four, and then for here, okay, fill the pool here. And then for the second load, for example, second load will be two tier. And then last load will be three tier. Ha. So what should I do? What I told you, in the ports, generally for these wire loading coils, they always want two times. Okay, two shifts for the bulldozer. They put bulldozer on the tank top, load here, and then here, and then fill the pool. And then put the plates here and here, put the bulldozer again. And then load the cargo as much as remaining cargo they put. Also here, finish, and then take the bulldozer. Because they don't have unlimited bulldozer, other vessel will come, they want to put the bulldozer in other hold, okay. So you cannot tell them, okay, I need bulldozer now, send me the bulldozer. You have only two chance. In one chance, finish first, and then remaining tier, you finish here, and then they will fill the pool again. Very, very important. So in that case, okay, for the first lot, I just draw again. Here. I just draw completely again. This is better writing. Yeah. This is hatch opening. This is aft, correct? This is forward. This is aft. This is forward. Okay. They put bulldozer. They put four tier here, correct? 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, and then take the bulldozer, send another vessel or another hold. Okay, with the crane, they just fill the pool. So this is my first load, for example, first discharging. And then they put the plates here again, put the bulldozer inside again. So let's say, for example, this is first load, second load, and third load. Okay, first load, 40 years. Huh? Let's say second load, let's say, for example, 2 tier only. And then third one will be, I just calculate, for example, it will be how many tiers? Let's say 3 tiers, okay. So what should I do in that case? In that case, you will tell them, we just calculate like this. So the initial 2 tiers, they just sent with the second lot, and then remaining 3 tiers, okay. This is 2 tier, this is 2 tier, and then 3 tier. This is lot 2, this is lot 3, and then they put bulldozer, and then they fill the second lot pool. Make load separation. Load separation very, very important. Also, I forgot to tell you, load separation. When the load finish, load separation very, very important. Load separation. Okay, second load separation. And then load separation. So, they put bulldozer here, make level, load separation. But they put bulldozer here, when finish this. Second load separation. And then load the remaining one. Okay, transfer bulldozer here. Make the second load separation, and then remaining. And then okay, fill the pools. Okay, this is the general rules about this wire loading coils, debarring coil loading. Okay, we just proceed with the pictures. Okay, one more thing. If it is box shape, okay, no problem. But if it is bulk carrier, what should we do? For this, hold number 2, 3 and 4. For example, 5 hold Panamax bulk carrier. You are working, okay. In this hold number, this is hold number 3, for example, like this. Okay. So how I will calculate how many tier, how many row it will be. Okay, what I told you before, separate the tree, correct? Like this. I am looking from the forward. Okay, here is, let's say, starboard side, here is port side. I am looking from the aft, correct? This is hole number 3 or number 2 or number 4. This area, just take the average height, calculate like this. Okay. Calculate what, this is the beam, this is the length, this is the square meter. What is the one coil square meter? It will take that much pieces. And then you come here, okay, this is the beam, this is the length of the cargo, this is the square meter. How many layers, how many tier it can take. And then when I come here, okay, same. This is the average. You just calculate like a box, okay. This is the beam, this is the length, and then how many pieces in one layer. So total I can take that much, and then this is my hatch coming area, I can take that much. But also, okay, I just, şimdi we were looking from the aft, now we will look from the side. Okay, this is my tank top, this is forward corrugate, this is aft corrugate, this is aft, this is forward. So what should I consider with this one? What I told you, not only think about the loading, also consider discharging. So when you are making cargo plans for these wire rodding coils, deformed bearing coils, you must know about the discharging method. Why? Okay, here, let's say this cargo hold can take until this cross deck height, let's say 15 tier, okay. Also same here, the height will take 15 tiers. And you need to load this cargo hold until, let's say 15 tiers. Okay, they accept, okay, no problem. Okay, this is not good example. We just tell like this. Pardon. Just assume this until this cross deck high can take 10 tier, okay, 10 tier here, 10 tier here, but you need to load until 12 tier. Okay, you are loading deformed bearing coil, you can load 12 tier, no, it will be no problem. So, but what is the problem? If we, for example, what I told you, check this photo. What about the loading method? If they were, you see, if they will be able to load, you see here, if they will be able to load until the very high, until the cross deck, maybe because of this bulldozer, they will not able to load. Okay, you see here, and then what about the load? This is another, you see, this is another method of loading. They are filling the pool with this one, they finish with the bulldozer, the underside, and then they fill with this crane. This is another loading method, you see the problem here. Maybe they will not able to load until the top, because you see here is one sling, and this one, you see this is different. There is a blade, they can directly load. What about the loading method? So, also you must know and consider this one. If they will be able to load until very high under cross deck, or they will not able to. Okay, maybe they able to load. Okay, they load very high, but in discharging port, what will be the discharging method if they will be able to take this cargo from this corner, very corner? Maybe they cannot make this one. It is very, very important. So, in that case, okay, generally, 8 tier here, and then, what we are doing? We are doing like this. Pardon. This is not a good... I just draw from one side. Okay, I think you understand the problem. I am just drawing from the one side of the cargo hold. I am just drawing only the forward side. Okay, this is Okay. This is forward. I am not driving the off part. Okay. So I just make 8 tier here. Okay. And then the remaining tiers will be go like this. Okay. Very, very important. Ha, so here will be gap. Here will be gap. This area will be empty because of the loading limitations. Correct. Ha. Here is until here 8 gap. This is 9, this is 10, this is 11. So what I calculate, I will normally according to my cargo plan, I will load all the cargo hold. No, I will not able to. This is also another problem. So you must know what I told you. This is the cargo hold. I am just quickly drawing like this, like this, like this, like this, like this. So divide 3, huh? Here, here, area, area length, area length, area length. In this part, maybe not able to load area length. Correct. So this is another problem. So you just make your calculations until this level. Okay. Until the topside hoppers beginning. Always. And then for the remaining, you must know about some additional information because of this one. Okay. Maybe, for example, you just make four tier first and then you put some plate here, put the bulldozer here and bulldozer able to load very very high. Okay, you just load until the corner. Okay, and then you fill the pool. But what about if they will be able to discharge? Maybe they will discharge only by the crane, only by the sling. It will be very very big problem for everybody. How they will take this one if they only use the crane when they are discharging? Okay, they can discharge cargo from the middle, make a pull here. If they will discharge with the bulldozer, okay, they make a some pull here, put bulldozer here. Okay, bulldozer take cargo from the, it will take too much time. Generally when they are discharging, they are directly discharging with the sling. There is no bulldozer. Okay, it is very very important. So what will be my cargo until here? Okay, like a stair. This is one of the important thing. I change the color. I draw again. Okay. Don't forget this one. Like a stair. I just change also this. Don't forget. Very, very important. This is one way. Another way. Okay. I load until here. Okay. And then remaining I load like this. Hatch coming no problem, but don't forget the tier must be not more than 4 tier difference between the last one. You understand what I mean? This is very very important things. Okay, and then we come to pictures. Okay, for hole number 1 and hole number 3, say hole number 5 for example, because they are not box shape holes, have some curve. Correct. Like this. For example, this is hole number 1. And this is hole number 5, for example. How I will calculate this one? You cannot calculate. What we will do? Okay, what we will do for this curved shape holes, we will use volume. Okay. So you just take the bale capacity. And then you just calculate with the bale how many pieces it can take. Okay, it is enough my target cargo or not. Okay, and one of the important thing, you can calculate this one with the bale capacity divided by one cargo volume. But for this bale capacity, what is important? I want to show you something. Şimdi when we are coming here, pardon, this is not a good picture. Dur bakayım, just a moment. This one, very good example. Şimdi, when we are calculating volume, how will we calculate? What I told you? The diameter, for example, 1.2. So 1.2, 1.2, 1.2, each tier I will calculate 1.2? No. Don't forget, you see here, this is the first one, this is the other one, but the other one going also inside. So what I mean is this, this is what, pardon, this is one of my coil, this is another coil, correct, and this is the top coil, correct. You see, so the diameter here is 1.2. okay, very good, the diameter is 1.2, but here this is, pardon, I changed the color again. You see, I just draw just little, pardon ya. Yeah, I am using mouse actually, very difficult to draw. This is cargo, the one drum coming, the other one coming, the top cargo coming like this. So you see here some area, so this 2 tier height will be not 2.4, it will be about 2 meters, correct, because this is not exactly start from top of the dam, it is going between them. So you can calculate the height from this one. Okay, so how will you calculate, by when you calculate by the volume, this is also another thing to consider. Okay, so it will be not exactly, so what will you assume, what I mean, so how will you use this one in the volume calculation? You will use like this, pardon. What we were doing when we are calculating, we need to volume of this wire rodding coils, correct. So I told you 1.35 the length and the diameter is 1.2, not anymore 1.2, it is 1, very simple. Okay, 1 multiply 1.35, 1.35 cubic meters. So what is the volume of the bale volume of the cargo number one? Let's say 1350. Okay, how many pieces it will take? It can take 1000 pieces. Okay, actually nothing to do this one, and then just about one layer how it will take. Actually you just take just average, just other thing you cannot do too much actually. What I mean the average, this one for example, this is the shape of my hole number one. Very very strange shape, you just take the average, nothing to do. Okay, so it will, you can calculate the height from the average weight. So this is the length, this is the beam, this is the length square meter. Okay, you just calculate from the average, just think it about bucks from the average. Okay, and then same like same for the hole number five also. Okay, okay, we continue with the photos. Actually my friends, I am really very very busy and very tired, so I am sorry for the cigarette. Kids not watch this one, but you know the life is not always very good. Nothing to do. Okay. Yeah, okay, this is the loading method, very easy actually. I have already shown. This is one of the another. You see this cargo also one hopper here, also in the corrugate have some with the angle it is coming, not directly up and down. And then here you see when you are loading, it is very very big problem here. Actually this is not very very big, this is just very big problem. What is the very big problem? This, you see here the protection of the Australian leather starts. Okay, you just make the tiers, when you come here you cannot load cargo here, but this is closed protection, it is, that is why very big problem. If it is only platform directly, it is very very big problem, because you cannot load to top of the platforms, you will collapse the platform. Especially the lower platform, you will damage. It will be very big problem. So you will have to leave here empty. Correct. It will be another big problem. So it will be they have to put some I will show in the picture if I can. I think I just arrange one like this. You see here, they just load until here remaining. Remaining tiers, they will load around it, but şurada var mı? This is also protected. Yeah, if it is not protected, what they should do? Actually, they should do some woodens, but long damages. Okay. Otherwise, they will damage your platform. Same like here, you see. This is a directly platform here. And it is open. There will be some gap here or if they load top of the platform, it will damage. So instead of gap, they should, for example, okay, this is my aft corrugate, for example. And here is the platform. Going like this, here is the other upper platform and going up the vertical ladder platform. What should we do? We load here. Load. Okay. When they come same level to top of here, they should put some long damages. And then the other tier, they load top until here. When come level, if they will load more, okay. Just put and then put the other tier to top of this. Otherwise, it will damage your platform. Or there will be some same like corridor, manhole. Here some will be gap, it will be problem. Collapse of the cargo. Okay. This is another problem. You have to speak with the foreman about this one in the beginning. And what kind of wooden they will put? If they put very thick wooden, it will damage. When you put top of the cargo, it will push down. You know what is the problem here? They just put one coil here, another coil here. They put the damage like this, exactly sharp edges here. And then they put another coil to top of it. Okay, this will make start pressure all the weight of the cargo and then with the corner it will damage the cargo these two. Okay. This is another problem. You will damage two coils, three coils, how many pieces? Okay. This is another problem. You have to consider this one also. Okay. You see these ropes, these are load separations. Don't forget. After each load, always load separation. Very very important. Ha, if different loads but will be discharge same port, okay, better to make load separation. But if they are different discharges port, 100% they must make load separation. Don't forget this one. Okay. Okay, we just proceed. Okay, I show this one, show this one. But you see here, if for example, if one row is half, they must make lashing. Okay, very very important. This is load separation. Why they didn't make lashing here? Because I think we will load some another load, but same discharging port. If it is side to side, no need. But if there is some gap, they should make lashing for this, like this. And then one like here, same here, also for this one, some lashing they must make. Correct. Okay, we proceed. This is load separations. Sometimes port separations, sometimes load separations. Okay. This is one of the another problem. That is why I tell you, calculate by the volume. Okay. Nothing to do. Yeah, for the height you just calculate just roughly. Okay. For the remaining, when they put the second time the bulldozer, you just call the foreman and with the super cargo, you calculate together, okay? Because if you calculate only yourself and you tell them, oh, if any problem, they will tell you, you told us like this, like this. Okay, all together we calculate. It is better. If any mistake, okay, you can make a cross check. Always better. Okay. So prevent mistake. There is no room for error. Correct. I like this word too much. No room for error. Yeah, this is all. You see after you see this is the bars, square bars. You can load top of this because these are very very light. Correct. After load the sides and the under cross decks, okay, with the crane, they directly start using. Okay. Always better to put tonnage to size. Always. Because hold sweating will happen. 100%. If you are loading hot climate, you are going to cold climate, hold sweating will happen. Correct. So, not touch cargo. As much as possible, minimize touching. You see, here is the hand straps, you see, the ratchet tensioner. They just make the lashing by hand. They can make lashing by hand, for this cargo no problem. But the coils, they must make with the pneumatic tensioner with the metal straps. For the bars, only the top 2 or 3 tier with the... It must be with the not with the pardon the belt slings with the ratchet. For the bars, it is better to make with the wire. For the wire rodding coils, the debarring coils, okay, they can make with the ratchet tensioner by hand, no problem. But for the coils, hot rolled, cold rolled, okay, with pneumatic. With the metal straps they must make. What was the rule? If it is less than 15 ton, only one metal strap is enough. But it is more than 15 ton, okay, double. All the metal strap lashing must be double. And what was the purpose for this lashing inside the cargo hold? Was prevent initial movement, okay. That was the rule. Okay, they just thought like this. What I mean, for example, you see here is 4 tier and then directly other tier start. It is not a good practice. Maximum 3 tier. Okay, maximum. But as much as possible 2 tier is enough. Okay, don't forget this. If it is, for example, 5 tier, 6 tier and then directly pull, it is no good. Don't forget this one. Actually not make like this. Maximum 3 tier, but as much as possible the level 2 tier is enough. Okay. You see 2 tier and then load separation starts. Okay. Yeah, this is another cargo. I will explain in the next video about this one. You see here is not good practice, but sometimes for the curved hold, sometimes nothing to do. Yeah, this is you see here they just take there are anyway, okay, this is not important. Okay, this is the stevedore problem actually. Okay, you see here you see here also sometimes they just need to supply the cargo with the wooden lanages. Okay, sometimes to make it exactly same row, because if you become away from the order, it will be a very big problem. Okay, as much as possible make it very good shape loading for that kind of cargo. Otherwise, when you are going the up, it will be big problem. Okay, don't forget this one. As much as possible in good order, in good visual order. Okay. And for this one, you see, they supply with the woodens. Sometimes like this nothing to do actually. It is not a good practice, but sometimes nothing to do. Okay, especially for this, you see here is bars, here is road, so not enough space, not all of them same size. You see, this is short, this is long, this is short. So some, you see here is long, this is short. Sometimes nothing to do. This is another. Wow, this is very good loading actually. You know, very very good. You see here is not good, but for that holes 1 and 5, nothing to do too much. Yeah, this cargo loading I will make another video. Okay, because this is another headache for this one. Yeah, actually okay, so I can also explain just shortly, because if they in the voyage, if they fix this cargo for your vessel, actually they must attend the super cargo for this cargo. What is this cargo? This cargo, you know what is MDF? It's some kind of compressed wooden. Okay. Pardon. Not this one. This one. Pardon. I just. Hop. Anyway, I just erase. Just quickly, I just erase. Şöyle yapalım. Yes, this is some kind of compressed wooden sheets, okay, and they are in packing like this. There is very big problem. If your vessel is box shape, it is no problem. You see, this vessel is almost box shape. Only problem here, they just supply with the wooden stagings. If very big gap, supply with wooden stages, but for the small gaps, they just, these are inflatable dunnage bags. Okay, they have some manual pump, the, how can I say, the electrical pump, hand pump. They just float this one. These are very strong actually, up to 30, 30 tons. They can, when you they are enough to carry 30 ton pressure. But if sharp edge, it will be problem. But directly cargo, they can lift 30 ton. They are very very strong. Okay. And actually, this stagings, wooden stagings take too much time. But for this one, these are very very easy, and just directly inflatable in 1 minute. They can inflate this one. Very very fast damaging method. But what is the problem with this one? If your vessel same like here, almost box shape. Only here is some hopper. Okay, but it is better not to hopper. but if it is not box shape, very very big problem. So what is the golden rule for this cargo? You see, this is the, for example, aft part of the cargo hold. This is the forward part of the cargo hold. So here no problem. Also you see some of them different sizes. If any photo I show you, these are homogen, these are homogen. For example, you see here different, here different. Some of them packing height different, some of them just not very high, some of them longer, some of them shorter. Okay, so in this cargo, as much as possible same sizes together, okay, and same sizes together, big pieces on the down, small pieces on the top, okay, of the cargo hold loading. So here very regular, you see there is no problem. But when you come to forward, too much problem. What is the golden rule for this cargo? What is the Gordon rule? When you finish the first layer, you finish the cargo loading, okay? Because if you group this cargo by the packing list, okay, same sizes, same heights, you group how many pieces, and according to this one, you make your calculation. Actually, what kind of calculation? Manual calculation for this one, nothing to do. Okay, this one, for this one, if you put the cargo, first layer, all the top layers will be same. You see here, we just finish here, we just calculate until there. And then actually here, loading sometimes randomly. Okay, you just stay inside the cargo hold. You tell the foreman, okay, send me this one, send me this one. Most probably from the producer of this cargo. But not the shipper guy directly has to come here because they have to call to factory. Okay, send me this one. Because these are water sensitive cargo. If rain, they cannot load this cargo. So they will call to factory, okay, we need that pieces. That size, that pieces, send me with the trucks, okay, I need that much trucks, send me that cargo, so they will supply you one by one loading for the first tier. When you finish the first tier, okay, remaining is not too much problem. And that is why big pieces on the down, small pieces, but you see here, for this cargo hold, if any photo, pardon. Here you see also some hoppers. Here you see some hopper here, some hopper here. So actually for this one, actually this is very big headache. Why? What I told you, here is big pieces and top small pieces. But sometimes even if small, it can be this cargo packings also have some different flexibility. Okay, some cargo packings are thick and these are not flexible MDF. Some of them very very thin, they can very flexible, so it will be no problem for this one. For the corners, sometimes you see here, I will show you one picture. Also you have to consider flexible. Bak, you see here is very big gap. What we did for this one, you see here, we just supply with this inflatable dunnage bags and we put this cargo to top of it here. You see why we were able to make this one, because even if we load some more cargo to top of it, this cargo, this packing is flexible, will be no problem. But some of them thick pieces, okay, inside the packing thick pieces and rough pieces, they are not flexible. This is also another problem. Okay, you just consider this one. Just have some idea. It is enough. Okay, this is also another problem for this cargo. And you see, these are big pieces on the down. This is another. I think I didn't take picture for this. No. Anyway, small pieces on the top. Because for this vessel, you see the beam is coming closer and then much more closer in the hatch coming. So small pieces in the down, big pieces in the down. Fill the gaps with the flatable bags, tonnage bags. And if very big gap, fabricate staging with the wooden platform. Okay. So this is another headache. But don't forget this one. If you finish the first layer, you finish the loading. Okay. Okay, thank you very much for watching. Okay. With the next videos, I will continue as much as possible. Okay, see you.